What's up, everybody? My name is Peter Rock. I am from Overcoming Faith Church, Thicker Road, where Jesus is Lord. Welcome to today's online Sunday school service. Today I'm going to be alone. What are you doing here?
See, I've come.
To do what?
See, to host.
But I thought today you are going to be alone. See, all those days you were alone. Now this one, you are
to be alone, my foot.
Come, let's just do it. Let's just do it.
Let us leave that. I want to challenge you in the Bible.
Hey, I'm not afraid. Let's do it. Let's do it.
The Egyptian name of Joseph.
Zephaneth-Panel.
You are almost Zephaneth-Panel, not Panel.
Okay.
The wife.
Asphina.
No. Asenath.
Okay.
Let's leave that.
Okay.
Twende kwa Moses.
Okay, twende kwa Moses. You go.
Aya. Great grandfather Moses.
Levi.
Grandfather.
Zohar.
Kohar.
Okay.
Watoto.
Gaho.
Tao juangi wewe.
Gosh.
Gashon na Elieza na wife yake ni Zipora.
Okay.
Kuni ujuangi vitu wewe.
Atio yu najua unajua hii corona. No, imekuwa imetukalia sana.
Imewakalia. Sawa. Let's see what the children have for us.
Who's your favorite character in the Bible? Mimi ni happy hivyo.
Moses.
Okay. Mine is David. Which one? Do you know how to draw?
Not really.
Good. See, I found you.
Do you know how to sing?
Yes, I do.
Haya, next time, before we start the show, utatuimbia.
Utawaimbia.
Sawa, tutasikia vile voice yetu inakwanga mbaya. Let us see what the children have for us.
Emmanueli, Amenitendea. Emmanueli, Amenitendea. Emmanueli, Amenitendea.
Amenibariki,
Amenibariki.
Amenibariki,
Amenibariki. Emmanueli, Amenibariki. Emmanueli, Amenibariki.
Had many sons.
Many sons.
So Father Abraham, I am one of them, and so are you. Just praise the Lord, right hand. Father Abraham, had many sons.
Had many sons.
So Father Abraham, I am one of them, and so are you. So let us praise the Lord, right hand. Father Abraham had many sons,
had many sons.
Oh, Father Abraham, I am one of them, and so are you. So let us praise the Lord, right hand, left hand, right foot. Father Abraham had many sons,
had many sons.
Oh, Father Abraham, I am one of them, and so are you. So let us praise the Lord, right hand, left hand, right foot, left foot. Father Abraham had many sons, many sons, oh Father Abraham. I am one of them, and so are you. So let us praise the Lord, right hand, left hand, right foot, turn around. Father Abraham, and many sons, oh Father Abraham. I am one of them, and so are you. So let us praise the Lord, right hand, left hand, right foot, turn around, we down.
Yo, welcome back to the second segment. Let us welcome Teacher Carmelita. Welcome, Teacher Carmelita.
Thank you, Rock and Favor. Welcome to today's Sunday school lesson. We continue with our main topic, the fruit of the Spirit. And today, our subtopic is kindness. But before we go on, we have guests with us today. I want them to introduce themselves. Let's start with our extreme right. What is your name?
My name is Toria Wangoi. I am 9 years old.
And where do you worship?
I worship in OFC, Overcoming Faith Church, Thika Road.
Okay. Next, we have a young man here. Please tell us your name, your age, and where you go to church.
My name is Fadili Mwangi David. I am from Overcoming Faith Church.
And how old are you, Fadili?
I am 7 years old.
All right. Very good. Let's continue. Remind us your name, young lady.
My name is Sheva David. I am 10 years old and I worship at Overcoming Faith Church.
And lastly.
My name is Tamara Modoni. I am 8 years old. I worship in Overcoming Faith Church, Thika Road.
Okay, now that we know the names of our guests, let's start with the word of prayer. Almighty and everlasting Father, we thank you today that, Lord, even as we learn about kindness, you may open our hearts so that we desire to be more and more kind. And Lord, may you teach us the kindness that comes from you. We thank you, Lord, that all the children gathered here are ready to hear from you. And Lord, as we continue, may you continue ministering to us. Send us the Holy Spirit so that we are filled with kindness. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Okay. Now, before we go on, I want us to sing a song. The song is called My God is So Big and Mighty, There's Nothing My God Cannot Do. Okay? Are we ready?
Yes.
Do we know the song?
Yes.
All right. There we start. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do for you. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do for you. The mountains are His, the rivers are His, the stars are His running wild too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do for you. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do for you. Okay, we've heard that our God is so big, so strong and mighty, there's nothing He cannot do for us because He's the creator of everything. Now, before we go on, I want the children to talk about today's lesson. And as I've said, our subtopic is kindness. Okay? Now, let's start with Toria. Toria, what do you understand by the word kindness?
Kindness is when your friend has fallen, you help her to stand up.
Okay, when your friend has fallen down, Toria has said, when you help them to stand up, you're being kind. That is kindness. Fadhili, what do you know about kindness?
Kindness is when you are being good to other people.
Very good. When you are good to other people, it means you're a kind person. What about you, Tamara?
Kindness is Using polite words.
Very good. Do you know an example of those polite words?
Excuse me.
Very good. When you use the word excuse me, it means you're being polite. And lastly, favor. What do you understand by kindness?
Kindness is helping others. Like when your friend in class doesn't have a pencil, you help him or her.
Very good. Sharing is also part of kindness. Okay, now let's go on and talk about kindness. Now, being kind is being caring, friendly, and generous towards others. Just as we've heard from the children, helping others, like when someone falls, you help them, you lift them up, doing good and deeds and being generous with others is kindness. Okay, now the opposite of kindness is being unkind. If you are an unkind person, you use bad words, or we say you are mean, like the children who bully others in school. We can say those are unkind people. Okay, now before we go on, let's hear what the Bible says. In Matthew 20:29, we have the story of two men who were sitting by the roadside. These two men were sitting by the roadside and Jesus was passing, okay? The two blind men. So let's read Matthew 20 from 29. And as they went out of Jericho, a great crowd followed them. And behold, two blind men sitting by the roadside. When they heard Jesus was passing by, they cried out, "Have mercy on us, Son of David." The crowd rebuked them. So was the crowd kind or unkind?
The crowd was unkind.
Very good. The crowd was unkind. The crowd rebuked them, telling them to be silent. But they cried out the more, "Lord, have mercy on us, Son of David." And Jesus stopped and called them, saying, "What do you want me to do for you?" They said to him, "Lord, let our eyes be opened." And Jesus, in pity, touched their eyes, and immediately they received their sight and followed him. Jesus was kind enough to stand because he heard the voice of these two blind men. Remember, the crowd told them to be silent and to keep quiet so that they are not heard by Jesus. But Jesus heard their cry and was kind enough to pray for them, and he healed them and he restored their sight. So what does that tell us about Jesus? Is Jesus kind or unkind?
Jesus is kind.
Very good. Jesus is kind, and that is why when he hears our cry, even today when we pray, Jesus hears our cry and he listens to us and he's kind enough to heal us. Okay? Now, how can we be kind to other people? As the children in the studio have given the examples, we can be kind by sharing. It's one of way of being kind. We can also be kind by apologizing. When you're passing by and someone is seated down and you step on their toes and they say, "Ouch, you just stepped on me." What do you do, Tamara? Do you just pass and go?
No, you say sorry.
Very good. You tell them, "I'm sorry, I didn't know I stepped on you," okay? Now, using polite words like please, okay? Fadhili, if you want to borrow a pencil in class, do you just take someone's pencil?
No.
What do you do?
You say, "Please give me a pencil."
Very good. You say, "Please, may I have your pencil?" Now, what about at home? Okay? Do we help people? Because you've told me kindness is also helping at home. Do we help at home?
Yes.
For example, what do you do?
Wash dishes.
Very good. If your mom tells you to wash dishes and you do it, it means you are a kind person. Okay? If you are told to help at home or to look up, after your younger brother or sister when your mom is going out, and you say, "No, I cannot," Does it mean you're a kind person?
No.
It means you are an unkind person. Okay. Now, let's now think about other people. Okay. Are other people always kind to us, or sometimes they are not kind?
Sometimes they are not kind, but sometimes they are kind.
Yes, so we have kind and unkind people. So what do you do when you have unkind people? Do you stop being kind to them, or you continue being kind to them, Tamara?
You continue being kind to them.
Very good. You continue being kind to them. And this kindness may cause them to start being kind to other people. We have an example that you're going to use, okay? I want someone to test this juice. Who's going to test it? Hey, Feva is very ready to test the juice. Tell me how it tastes, if it's sweet or bitter or it's tasteless.
It's sweet,
okay? Put the glass back. And I want you to test this water. Toria, test the water for us. Does it have any sugar? Is it sweet?
No, it's tasteless.
It's tasteless. Now, let's use this example that the sweet juice is a person with kindness. It's a person with kindness. And the plain water that is tasteless is a person without any kindness. So what do you do as a child of God? As a child of God, you don't stop showing kindness. You don't stop showing kindness, okay? You continue being kind. So that the water that is tasteless, that is the person without kindness, if they step on you and they don't say sorry, you don't abuse them. You say, next time you step on me, remember to say you're sorry. You add kindness to them. If you want to borrow something from them, you don't just snatch it. You ask politely. When someone has a problem, you help them. When you're playing with your friends, they fall down, you help them. You are being kind. When mom has left her purse at home and it has money, you don't take that money and go to buy sweets, okay? You take that money and keep it for mom. You are being a kind person. So at the end, can you taste that juice for us and say if it's sweet or it's still tasteless? Is it sweet?
Yes,
so by being kind to other people continually, every day being kind and kind and kind, it causes them also to be kind. So just like the juice in the first glass, the second juice is also sweet. So if someone was not kind, we continue being kind to them so that at the end they will be kind. All right?
Yes.
So have you understood today's lesson?
Yes.
All right. Now, As we wind up today's lesson, let's sing another song. Let's sing another song, okay? About Noah. Do you know the story of Noah?
Yes.
Uh-huh. God told Noah to do what?
To build an ark.
Okay, let's sing that.
God told Noah to build an ark, to build an ark, to build an ark. God told Noah to build an ark, and Noah built an ark, and Noah built an ark.
It was gong, 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 and ziggy, ziggy, ziggy.
Gong, 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 and ziggy, ziggy, ziggy. Gong, 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 and ziggy, 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 and Noah built an ark, and Noah built an ark. Animals went in two by two, two by two, two by two. The animals went in two by two, and Noah built an ark, and Noah built an ark.
It was gong,
gong, gong, and ziggy, ziggy, ziggy. Gong, 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 and ziggy, ziggy, ziggy. Gong, 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 and ziggy, ziggy, ziggy. And Noah built an ark, and Noah built an ark.
The rains came down
for 40 days, 40 days, 40 days. The rain came down for 40 days, and Noah built an ark.
right. Now, our memory verse comes from Matthew 20, verse 31. Matthew 20, verse 31. Have mercy on us, son of David. The crowd rebuked him, telling them to be silent. But they cried out some more, Lord, have mercy on us, son of David. 31 says, the crowd rebuked them, telling them to be silent, but they cried out, have mercy on us, son of David. They were crying out for Jesus to show kindness to them. And Jesus showed kindness to them, and he healed them, and they knew the goodness and the kindness of Jesus. So there is the end of our lesson today. We thank you for being with us, and we hope that you've learned to be kind to other people. Just as Jesus was kind enough to hear the cry of the two men who were seated by the roadside, he heard their cry, he stopped, and he went and he healed them. Okay? So let's end our lesson with a word of prayer. Because you're faithful and you're merciful, we thank you because you're a kind God. And God, as we've learned to be kind today, may you continue helping us to be kind to other people so that we may cause them to be kind also. Lord, may you help us to keep the word that we've learned today in our spirit so that we may continue bearing the fruits of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
You may be seated there at home, but you are not born again. You've heard our lesson today, and you would want to start bearing the fruits of the Holy Spirit. Please repeat after me. Lord Almighty,
Lord Almighty,
I thank you because you've heard my cry today.
I thank you because you have heard my cry today.
I am a sinner.
I am a sinner.
But I confess that I am born again today.
But I confess that I am born again today.
Forgive my sins.
Forgive my sins.
And write me in the book of life.
And write me in the book of life.
I receive salvation in Jesus' name.
I receive salvation in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
If you have said that prayer with us, it means you are now born again. Don't keep the good news to yourself. Share with other children. Share with your parents and go to church. Thank you for being with us today. We are glad you are able to join us. And until next time, I remain your teacher, Carmelita, and from all of us, it's
goodbye.
Thank you for joining us today. Do not forget to join us next Sunday for another wonderful Sunday school service like this. Check us out on our social media platforms, Facebook, Overcoming Faith Church,
and YouTube, OFC Ministries.
Do not forget to join the main service at 10 a.m. We were your host,
Peter Rock,
and Fever David.
Bye.
Light of the world, you step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see.
Beauty that made this heart adore you. Oh, my.
my God.